Folks, I have a brand new favorite truck series diecast in the 1/64 scale, and here's Chase Elliott's 2020 Hooters Chevrolet Silverado. Hell, howdy, folks, it is Diecast Buffet here again, back with a epic truck diecast review. It is Chase Elliott's Hooters truck. When's the last time they made a freaking Elliott truck diecast? Never. They made two this year. They made the iRacing one and the Hooters one. And I tell you what, this diecast was so freaking popular, it got sold out on pre-orders, bro, from Plan B Sales. I couldn't freaking believe it, how popular this truck is. Now, believe it or not, this is actually on the alcohol base, limited edition adult collectible. And what's funny is they put this in Wave 6 of the 2020 NASCAR Authentics line, and it has a different bed cover sponsor, as it says Hooters Spirits over there. So this truck was ran at Atlanta. It's one of the Bounty Hunter trucks, I believe. And this thing is absolutely beautiful, and I cannot wait to freaking review it. So without further ado, let's go get this 2020 Hooters Chase Elliott Chevrolet Silverado right out of the box. Alrighty, folks, brand new out of the box. We got the base off of this truck, and oh my Jesus, it's already my favorite truck series diecast. Imagine that. The gloss black, that bright orange. It's not a day glow orange, but it's just a darn good, kind of like a buffalo wing orange. And I tell you what, man, this is a 24 truck. This is a updated version of the 24 Brett Moffitt truck we got. You know, of course, you already got two of those trucks. So technically, for the 24 trucks, you have four of the GMS 24s. Think about it. You had the Plan B Sales truck from last year with Brett Moffitt, the Patriotic one, and then you get the iRacing and the Hooters trucks for Chase Elliott. So for your truck series stop motion cats, you do get some options here. Now, this truck is, I'll be honest with you, this truck is absolutely stunning. This is a beautiful diecast, and it's certainly a very popular ad for the pre-order community. I mean, literally, this thing was sold out on PlanBSales.com. I had to order it from, I think, K-State, from K-State, because Plan B Sales was sold out. I mean, the pre-orders, generally, they allow as many pre-orders as possible, right? It's crazy. So you got the Hooters Al right there just chilling. You got the front end of the Chevrolet Silverado. And just look at that orange kind of bright transition fade behind the bow tie. Of course, the trucks are on a generic mold, but that doesn't bother me today, because I mean, this thing is stunning. A freaking Chase Elliott Silverado. That's just freaking epic, bro. So you got the GMS Racing logo. You got Silverado. You got the 24 on the top of the splitter. You have a orange kind of a ribbon above that. The bottom of the splitter is painted black. Of course, you got Simpson and Sunoco. Go over to the left side of this truck, and I tell you what, man, we got so many brand new Gold Series trucks coming up on the channel. I mean, you're not going to want to miss it, so make sure to go ahead and subscribe and hit that notification bell for that, because I'm talking boatloads of brand new merchandise right here on the channel. So you got Chase Elliott right there. You have this just a very modern, fast, almost like a comic book kind of like motion orange paint scheme. You know how like when a comic book character might move their arm and it has like some motion graphics? That's what it kind of reminds me of. Of course, you have the Hooters logo right there. A little bit of an oopsie right there on the first O. Or is it an O? Who knows? You'll have to ask Race Day 2011 on that one. You got Mobile One right there. You got Freightliner. Actually, no, that's not Freightliner. That's ETEK. I don't know what the heck that is. Got GMS Racing. 3M. Mechanics Wear. Wix Air Filters. SEM. Not sure what the other ones are. Got a very, very nice 24 font right there. Got the bow tie logo, the Chevrolet. Got GMS Racing once again. Not sure what that is. Love the Chase Elliott font. And it's kind of funny how he drove the 24 car in the Cup Series. Goes back down to the Truck Series, and he drives the 24 again. Of course, you got NASCAR race truck right there, Mobile One. Don't know what that is. Gander Outdoors Truck Series, Comedic, Holley EFI, and Tilt. Got Goodyear once again. You go over here to the tailgate of this truck, and wow, this thing is beautiful, man. Easily one of the best looking Truck Series diecasts, if not the best one ever produced so far. I mean, this thing is just, it's beautiful. It's kind of funny how the Cup car had the matte finish, satin finish, and then this one has the gloss finish. You got Hooters.com right there, Silverado. Not sure what that logo, the badge is right there. Very cool how you have the 24 right there on the back bumper. It's very nice. Of course, you have the Chevrolet bow tie. Spoiler is painted black there. Go get to the right side of this Truck Series diecast, and sweet baby Jesus, is this thing absolutely stunning, man. The orange, the black, Chevy Silverado, Chase Elliott. I mean, it's no wonder this is going to be one of the most popular Elliott diecasts, I think, of the year easily, but possibly all time. Who knows if they'll ever produce another Elliott Truck Series diecast. And, you know, if you remember back earlier this season when Kyle Busch was winning every truck race, there was a big bounty thing they set out. I think it was Harvick and the cat who owns Gander Outdoors. They were putting up a bounty for someone to beat Kyle Busch in a truck race and win it. And sure enough, Elliott kind of did that at the Charlotte truck race. He won that truck race, then of course he hopscotched and won over at the cup race that Wednesday night, that Thursday night. So of course, you know, all your contingencies are pretty well in a good spot here. They're not kind of all over the place. Very, very sharp looking truck. And of course, you go over to the roof of the cab, and wow, bro, this thing is absolutely beautiful. The Gander RV and Outdoors logo right there. And of course, I think next year it's going to go back to the Camper World Truck Series, if I remember correctly. I don't know where I read that. It might be wrong. I don't know. 24 right there, got the orange with a little bit of a white pinstripe. I always find it interesting how they take the door number and they kind of squunch it up and put it in a bottle, bottleneck it on the roof. Pretty cool. Of course, you go over to the bed cover of the truck, and they even put the paint scheme pattern on the bed cover, which is pretty nice, because usually they leave the bed covers, well, pretty plain, because really, you know, it's just, what can you do, you know? But they've got the Chevrolet bow tie there, you got your Hooter Spirits logo, and what's interesting about this is that the Gold Series edition of this truck has the Hooter Spirits logo, that's why it came on a base, but the actual NASCAR Authentics Wave 6 edition is actually different. So if you want to have a different bed cover logo, pick up the Authentics version, because it doesn't have the Hooter Spirits logo, from what I've seen at least. So that's actually kind of interesting how it doesn't have the alcohol sponsor. So essentially there's two versions of this truck produced. And again, I think if you could see this truck, if you could pick it up for, you know, your normal retail diecast price, I would absolutely recommend it, because this thing is going to dry up, in my opinion. This thing, I think, if they don't overproduce it, it's going to dry up. Like I said, the pre-orders got sold out for some of these diecast dealers. I think it was Plan B Sales it was sold out, because I tried to get it, and it just, I don't know. Either way, this thing is absolutely stunning. My favorite Truck Series diecast already. And, I mean, the Hooters logo, all of this truck is really cool. And I believe he ran this at Atlanta Motor Speedway back, I think it was actually, that first June weekend or the last May weekend when Harvick won. He ran this truck. It was a doubleheader, I believe, with the Xfinity program. But, wow, man. Tell me what y'all think about this 2020 Hooters Silverado down below in the comment section. Make sure to give the video a big thumbs up, like, comment, and subscribe. And of course, hit that notification bell down below so you don't miss any of the new 2020 Gold Series diecast. Of course, you know, the Wave 6 stuff, the Ty Dillon, the Brad Keselowski. We'll have those DMPs on the channel very soon, and possibly next Saturday. Who knows? Anyways, folks, thank you all so much for watching. Have a great day out there. And of course, you know, keep supporting the channel. It definitely means a lot to me. With all that being said, folks, stay humble. Diecast Buffet signing off, folks.